Grains, boulders, pineapples, moonstones, buttons, roses. No, no, you're not in a wild fever dream. You're under the sea, in a tropical coral reef. There are literally thousands of kinds of coral. Some are soft and others are hard. Some build reefs and others don't. The coolest thing about coral is that they're actually alive. Yeah, really, those things that you thought were rocks on the seafloor are living, breathing, swaying animals called polyps. The coral polyp can be as small as a poppy seed or as big as a grapefruit. And these little guys are the construction workers of the coral reef. So the polyp is all mouth and stomach. It just sits there on the seafloor, waving its stinging tentacles around, looking for its next meal. The polyp snares its catch with its stingy tentacles and stuffs them into its mouth hole. That prey might be a small fish, or they could eat maybe a tiny microscopic zooplankton, which are floating around in the water. As the polyp feeds and grows, it oozes out this limestone skeleton, and it grows and builds the reef millimeter by millimeter. This skeleton, this limestone skeleton, is what most people think of as coral. There's a lot of weird things about coral polyps, but probably the weirdest thing about them is that they actually have another organism living inside them. There's an algae, it's called zooxanthellae, and it's living inside the tissues of the coral polyp. All right, that's a hard word, so try saying it with me. Zooxanthellae. Try putting it all together. Zooxanthellae. So the polyp and the zooxanthellae are really good work buddies. The zooxanthellae photosynthesizes energy from the sun and shares that energy with the coral polyp. And the polyp says, right on, zooxanthellae, thanks a lot. In exchange for that, I'm gonna give you a home and some nutrients. It's what's called a symbiotic relationship. This is the relationship that we mess up when we wear the wrong sunscreen near a reef. The oxybenzone in some sunscreens increases a virus in the water that damages the zooxanthellae and bleaches the coral. Regardless of where you swim, your sunscreen could be damaging the weird and wonderful coral polyps that build a coral reef. Of course, you have to be sun smart, but also be coral conscious. Before you take the plunge, make sure that sunscreen is oxybenzone free. Hey, now you know.